Hey, what's up everybody? My name is Trophinet and welcome back to The Witcher 3 on the That Much difficulty. We're playing the Blood&Wine DLC, and as you can see, I kind of kept part of the Viper armor, so I'm still wearing the Viper chest armor, and that's the one I'm gonna use for now. I think I'm also using the Viper Venomous Steel Sword, so we're gonna see how that works out. But today, we're in Blood&Wine, and we're at Penastri's Hermitage. And over here, there's a very interesting side quest I heard about. So we need to talk to Penastri herself, and she's talking about something that torments her.
Choose me to torment. Begone, foul spirit.
Hello, Penastri.
You're tormented. By what?
Forgive me, but I must ask directly. Are you a man? I no longer trust my senses.
What do I look like to you, then? Am I something else in your eyes? A werewolf or something? But no, yes, I'm a man.
Meaning I'm physical, no specter or vision, if that's what you fear. Don't trust your senses? Why?
A foulness, a demon or wraith haunts me, grants me no rest. It wants something. I sense this, but know not what. Each day it appears. Carries, then leaves. It's here now. There, beyond the trees.
Oh, indeed it is.
Don't see a thing.
Or there's a cameraman with a black and white camera over there.
Yet you see it?
Only when I drink the brew, which brings a pain to my head. Nausea. But I endure these to keep an eye on the wraith, my tormentor.
Okay, and what does the demon look like?
This demon of yours. Can you
describe it?
What
does it look like me, then?
It is an enormous horse. Its hoofbeats pounding in the dark. It gallops to me, stops, stares, then runs on.
Sure it's not just a wild horse, run-of-the-mill?
The creature is not of this world. When it gazes at me, a terrible chill pervades my soul. It is evil condensed. Its eyes black, void. Each time it comes, terror grips me. I cease what I'm doing, still my breath and heart.
So a giant horse that haunts you. The brew, what's it made of? Are you drinking some hooch, lady?
What's your brew made of? Gotta wonder what's causing such strong visions. You drop in some mushroom, jumper tub, dancing dewlap?
Close. The common greytop. I see you know your herbs.
Greytop? Variety's extinct, if I recall correctly.
Nearly, but not quite. I was able to grow a few from dried spores. I'd hoped a brew of Greytop would reveal this nightmare. I was not wrong.
Far as I know, Greytop produces some powerful side effects. Though it can, in fact, reveal the hidden, the immaterial.
So she might have a point.
I see the evil. Better that than to know it is there. But not know where.
She has an interesting amulet around her neck. Let's talk about my pay.
Need to talk about how much I'll get paid first.
Is it gold you want?
Orens or Novigrad crowns. Florins will work too.
I've none of
them. Yeah, we'll go to the bank with
that. I've nothing, in fact. Just potatoes in the cellar. A good crop this year. Tend to this quickly, completely, and several sacks will be yours. Agreed?
Sacks of potatoes? Well, if you're gonna pay me in potatoes, I'm just gonna say I don't need any pay.
If that's the case, no pay required. Need those potatoes more than I do.
Yes, indeed. So we'll try to help, of course.
Fine. You seem sure something's out there. I'll see what I can do. Start by taking a look around.
So yeah, because otherwise that wouldn't be too much of an episode now, would it?
Tired as the grave.
Use your witcher senses to investigate the area and find out what's tormenting the hermit. Let's take a look around. Don't see something at first sight. But then I'm not really looking, am I? Is this? Leaves! No, dead butterflies.
Dead moths. Attracted to some ghosts like to the light of a candle.
Okay, and then they get burned by touching them?
Seems there's at least some truth to the hermit's ravings.
Okay, let's loot the place. Thank you for that. And the cat is really mad with me. Of course, because I'm stealing all her food. Loot this, the Flagellant's Manifesto. Fellow sons and daughters of Lebioda, the end is nigh. Mend your ways and put your faith in the good tome. For our prophet has written, to shun the pleasures of the flesh and shirk from comfort is at times recommended, and to value one's neighbor's fortune above one's own comfort is commendable. That is why we, the 8th-day flagellants, scourge ourselves and torment our flesh to ensure all folk of the world enjoy long and prosperous lives. Whatever evil, sickness or misconduct lurks in this world's dark corners survives not because we have been negligent in striking our backs with the whip. Okay then. Hermits.
Common gray top. Strong hallucinogen. Thought extinct. Don't often get to see that.
Yeah, make a note of that, Geralt. What's this on the bed?
Drops of blood on the pillow. Trail of them leading to the window.
Okay. I'm gonna have to check the other side, probably. I wanna know... Oh no, that window, apparently. Never mind. Let's take that formula. The other things are not really interesting.
Shutters closed tight. Need to check the other side, see if the trail continues.
Yeah, you don't like me, pussycat. The trail does continue. Makes me wonder why I didn't see that before, but... It is a magical witcher senses. Let's follow the trail.
Blood starts at the pillow, ends here. Medallion's still vibrating.
Okay, is the horse here then, but I just can't see it?
Something drinks the hermit's blood at night. That I know. Gotta talk to her. Maybe she can tell me something more.
Yeah, Geralt's clearly smarter than I am, because I didn't put the connection to her getting her blood drunk from her neck at night by the ghost. That's kind of creepy. Oh, I still love this place. Don't know what that great blob on the other side there's supposed to be, but I still love Toussaint. It's really, really nicely done. But
grant me but one whole day's rest. I beg you.
We will try to grant you a lot of rest, but here we go. Have you any puncture marks on your neck? Like vampire marks? Any herbs you want to sell? Life of a flagellant, why'd you choose this, actually? Yeah, I want
to
know.
Heard flagellants whip themselves to atone for all humankind's wrongs. To appease the gods, gain their forgiveness. That why you do it?
We've each our own reasons.
Ooh, those are hooks.
We seek to atone for the suffering of a living being, which once fell victim to another's vanity. I care not for humankind, preferring instead the company of animals.
So wait, another human being that made some mistakes. Maybe there's a connection with that wraith, but...
Most likely some kind of wraith's tormenting you. Can't tell what kind, though. Felt weak, spent lately? Noticed bite marks on your skin?
As I said, I feel weaker by the day. And bites, of course. There are lice and midges here aplenty.
This isn't lice. Something much bigger drinks your blood while you sleep.
But I do not sleep. Not a wink. He's always present. Always watching. I cannot bear it any longer.
So does it hypnotize her then?
Sadly, not much I can do. Can't exterminate it if I can't see it.
Oh, I know where this is going.
I shall make a brew of it for you. I've 2 mushrooms left. Enough for 1 dose. Perhaps then you'll see what I do.
Mushrooms can produce bad side effects. Yeah, that's true,
this
probably.
Mushroom, even in me, could produce some nasty, unpredictable side effects.
True. There is no knowing how Greytop would affect a mutated body.
But we've been through worse, right? So it could actually work.
A proper brew could be our only chance to figure this out.
Okay, ready to brew. My turn to drink it.
All right. High time we tried this.
Okay. That thing, that flogging thingy stick looks really painful if she's using that on a daily basis. But let's go for some hallucinations. Okay, are you done? Seems like you're done. Thank you. That was a serious transaction. Common Greytop brew.
If I start muttering something about unicorns or sorceresses, ignore it.
Okay, yeah, because, yeah, the stuffed unicorn. And Yeah, Geralt and Yennefer like having intercourse on that stuff, unicorn. Yep, Geralt, enjoy the hallucinations. This is gonna be interesting. Here we go, I suppose. Starts with a headache. Looks like he's having a hangover already. That's some really bad hooch. He looks rather panicking. And now he's looking like he's about to shit himself. Okay, bye Geralt. My mutated body can take anything. I'm not gonna be affected by this potion, yeah right. Okay, this is looking trippy. Where's the purple smoke coming from? Purple rain, purple... No, it's not raining. Never mind. Okay, don't see no wraith. Yeah, indeed.
Wow, this clover's amazing. Now that's what I call a bouquet.
Who said that?
Oh, you're awake. Had me worried. You were out way too long. Even considered giving you some white honey. Kind of hard to do with hooves, though.
Roach?
Roach can talk? Why do you sound so manly? My question would be, why do you sound like an absolute a-hole?
Your voice, it's, interesting. Gotta say, I expected a young mare to sound, girlish.
Based on what? Your vast experience with talking animals? Far as I know, I'm your first.
And he's a real American, isn't he? Seems the mushrooms did this.
Must be the brew that did this. Interesting side effect.
Great, isn't it? You should take this stuff more often. Got so many pointers I could give you.
Like spawning on the roof?
Sadly. Drinking this too often could prove fatal.
So hey, why do you always show up when I whistle? Yes, yes, let's ask the hard questions.
Hey, know how you always show up when I whistle? How's that work exactly?
Well, you're my human. Gotta be there when you need me. Yes, I'll be there for you, ooh, as the world falls down.
Okay, was
still
that a friend's
strange.
A friend's reference?
I cross the ocean when I call sometimes, but then get hung up on the tiniest fence. What's that about?
Yes.
What can I say?
Yes, I love this. This is amazing. Okay, need to track down this wraith. Let's go.
Listen, got this contract I need to finish before the brew wears off.
Right. Monster won't slay itself. Let me see. First up, I need to know what we're dealing with. Follow me, and try not to trample any plants or small animals.
Oh, okay. This is awesome. Oh, I want to kill a cow, by the way. This is a trophy for killing cows.
Geralt, we gotta inspect this area closely. I'll look for clues. You stand there and... Well, just stand.
Right.
Yeah.
Now look at that.
Roach has helped Roach investigate
don't
the area.
Don't see anything here.
These are hoof prints. Not just any old horses either. These were left by an astral being. Otherworldly. We gotta follow them.
How are you so smart? I'm... Okay then. This is interesting. Anything else?
Dead moths. Often mean a phantom's nearby.
Thanks, Captain Obvious. Now, what about the smell? Same whiff I caught at the cemetery in Vizima when we were hunting ghouls. The smell of death.
Smells normal to me. Not taking me for a ride, are you?
Seriously?
I can't even get on him, by the way. I can't even mount the guy. This is actually really, really,
all
really
right.
Well done.
Now I know what we're up against.
Okay. Do I need to talk to you? Well, I'm talking to my horse.
Right, Geralt. Let's sum up what we know so far.
Okay, we know pitifully little. Yeah, let's go with that.
Don't know much. It's a spirit of some sort. Torments the hermit for some unknown reason. It's immaterial, so I've got no idea how to fight it.
And it's a horse, a big horse.
Find it, that is.
Geralt, please, I got this. It's definitely an Umbra, an immaterial wraith. This one's assumed the form of a horse.
We kinda knew that already.
Umbra actually makes sense. Umbrea completely invisible, even to Witchers. But how can you be sure?
Because it's not invisible to me, Doofus. It's right over there.
Indeed it is. There it is. Oh, Christ. Okay.
It's getting away! Come on, Witcher, hop in the saddle! Gotta catch it!
Okay, let's catch it then.
That's it, Roach.
There's the Umbra! Let's go, Geralt! After it!
Okay, let's follow this thing.
Gonna save my strength a bit. No telling how long we're gonna need to keep running.
That was a stamina joke. Oh, horse stamina joke. Oh god, what are we doing? Chase the spirits to find out where it comes from.
We gotta have a man to horse talk. No offense, but your riding skills, they leave a bit to be desired, buddy.
You'd really do me a solid if you could apply a slightly surer hand, be a little more decisive about where you want me to go.
Sometimes I got no idea, buddy. Do I go left, right, cork where I'm standing?
Yeah, and it'd be great if you could respond more fluidly to my commands.
Hey, heard this one? Horse walks into a tavern, and the innkeeper says, "Hey, pal, why the long face?"
Ha! Oh, God. Shut up. Shut up, Roach.
Let's not lose sight of that Umbra. Can you see it now?
Yeah, it's right there. Run, Roach.
What the fuck do you think I'm doing?
Roach is cursing. The horse is fucking cursing. Yeah, I just did it myself. I'm actually really glad that Roach doesn't talk all the time, because this would get old really quickly.
I gotta ask, why do you sometimes buck me off in the middle of a fight?
First I've heard. Don't recall that ever happening.
Of course you don't.
Are we back where we came from?
Melted into thin air.
Okay. Defeat the rep. What? Defeat the restless spirit. Oh god!
Oh, fuck! Ow. Geralt, watch out!
Okay, I'm gonna go for Spectre Oil. Because I'm gonna guess, yeah, those are ghosts. Oh, hi.
Not bad.
Okay, these guys don't take any damage. Oh, they do. Oh, that one's dead. Okay. Hello! Pretty kitty! Okay, so that was half the health bar. Where's the rest? Okay, there's the rest, never mind. What's it now? Oh, more kitty cats. Oh, they're both dead. Okay. That was the health bar. Examine the gravestone. This is actually really, really cool. Okay, so let's check this out before everything falls apart. Let's not loot that. I'm not really sure what this
Some
is all about.
Some kind of glowy magic thing going on with this tombstone. We should check it out.
Hi, Roach. Toussaint Knight Steel Sword. Wait, I needed to check the gravestone, not loot this. Can I examine? Yeah, okay. Just in case Much anything happens if I remove the sword.
Knight died last year. Was more or less the same age as our hermit. Seems his spirit's become a horse-shaped umbra that's tormenting Panastri.
Why are you telling me this? I can read and draw my own conclusions.
Thinking aloud.
You can read?
Helps me focus.
The horse can read? That's not a revelation? Hi? What's happening? Okay, and now it's a dude.
It's the Umbra! Attack!
No,
Let
wait.
Let me explain!
Yeah, okay. Explain yourself.
Talk, but make it fast. Why are you tormenting the hermit?
She torments me! Refuses to forgive me! I'm denied peace in the afterlife, and it's all her doing! Each day I come and beg her for clemency.
Okay.
Beg her for clemency? You drink her blood, drive her mad with fear.
I don't know how to explain it, but yes, a monster's force takes me. Though I also know I'll not have peace till the day Panastri forgives me.
So he has the same pattern on his armor as the horse and the panthers had, so what's the link?
You and the hermit, How do you know each other?
We met as babes, grew up side by side. I loved her. Yet she was always sad. Nothing could cheer her. The world terrified her. I thought her gloom came from being poor. So I did my damnedest to take us from our village, make us a better life elsewhere.
Okay.
Became a squire, took her with me to the palace. But Panastri soon learned nobles are no more decent than peasants, not a speck. Once even I'd grown vile to her eyes, she fled the palace and joined the flagellants. I left the court to be near her, yet she cast me off. Said she didn't want to know me.
And Roach lost his interest. Or her interest.
When the whip bearers proved too hard-hearted for her too, she became a hermit. I see it clearly now, though I never understood her while alive. From the grave's dark depth, the living are bright, sharp flares. You see all their thoughts at once. Now I understand why she had to cast me off.
She's full of rage. Probably what turned you into an Umbra.
Okay. And then what's with the horse? Why appear to her as a horse?
Why take the form of a horse?
A horse? What do you mean? Each day since I died, a power lifts me from my grave and makes me run. Then I return with blood in my mouth.
So you don't have any control over that for some reason.
I don't know what this is, how it comes to pass, but I do know the torment will continue until she forgives
me. Is Geralt bored as well? This is great.
But she sees me as a horse, you say?
Yeah, we saw you as a horse as well.
Same way I saw you.
So begging for forgiveness, what would you do?
Must have hurt her something awful if she refuses to forgive you. Would rather see you suffer.
Or what did you do?
What did you do?
To her? Nothing. But my horse, I flogged it to death.
Ooh.
Pinastri, she saw this.
Roach wouldn't
Cowed
like that.
Stallion, my blaze. But he was a bucker and tossed me during a tourney. One I'd wanted to win badly. Pinastri had been so glad they'd let me stand. Me, a peasant's son. I wanted to win it for her. But that horse made me lose. Rage overcame me. I struck and struck until at last he fell.
Yeah, that was not really nice of you.
Oh, the regret. I beg you, forgive me. Absolve me in Blaze's very
name. I'm guessing you're asking Roach for forgiveness now? You don't deserve mercy. Not the one you should ask for forgiveness, indeed. Let Roach decide that.
Can't forgive you for that. Not in my power.
But your horse could? Please, I'd do anything. I'm desperate. Help me.
So wait, can any ghosts talk to Roach? Because that would be interesting. Doesn't deserve mercy, this one, or forgive him if you can. Yeah, we're going to try to resolve this peacefully, so forgive him if you can.
Could free his spirit, pardoning him on behalf of his horse. But you shouldn't do it if you don't think he deserves forgiveness.
Did a rotten thing. Got no excuse. Your horse was loyal. Did the best damn job he could. Cause that's how we horses are.
True. I know I deserved what befell me.
But we aren't vengeful, don't hold grudges, don't dwell on being left in monster-infested woods. So, in your poor Blaze's name...
Sorry, Roach.
I forgive you.
Oh, thank you. I feel... it's incredible. Such relief, such lightness.
Is he going? I think we did it. That kind of fixed everything. Thank you, Roach.
All right, then. Guess we might as well head back. Panastri's knights ought to be ghost-free from now on. Anything to add, Geralt?
Oh, we kind of have a few more questions.
Let's go see her.
No? Okay, then. Never mind. Would have been nice to see some more banter between these two. Not for the entire game, though. Some time later. Yeah, because we sprinted out like a madman. Behind an invisible horse.
Phantom's gone. Shouldn't torment you ever again.
I felt a change. I did. As if I'd been released from a cramped dunk cellar.
He was a friend of yours.
I had come to believe no one could help me. I'm grateful, Witcher.
Oughta thank my horse, actually. Phantom's departure, mostly Roach's doing.
Then I thank you too, noble creature.
Gotta admit, easy peasy with our powers combined. So, what now? We hit the path? Ride to the nearest notice board? Rustle up another contract?
Exactly. Though, effects of the bruise waning, I can feel it. Won't be able to understand you soon.
That's horseshit. I mean, I got so much more I want to tell you, and...
Aww.
Clever beasts, horses. Farewell, Witcher.
Yeah, a bit too clever for my taste. He was smarter than Geralt. That was amazing. Equine Phantoms completed. That was a very, very cool side quest. And character entry updated Roach. That was amazing. Really, really cool. Really, really nicely done. Another excellent side quest. And with that, I'm going to take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you did, don't forget to like this video right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye! Yeah,